of April, day 19 in the game. Carl on level 3. Still looking for bandits to fight now that I have some companions who can take care of the trade, pathfinding and other party skills. And here we have some we can chase. Swedish Lord, Baron Christopher Bjolke. Don't you get in my way when I'm chasing these bandits.
Today the gods will decide your fate.
Well, well, look at this. Your purse is quite heavy, methinks. Donate a little good silver to us and we'll pass by in peace, right? I'll give you nothing but gold steel, you brigand. Hold everyone in place. I think here will be a good spot. Marksman on here, holding F1 for the flag. Infantry here below. Cavalry go there. Everyone spread out a bit. I can't believe I missed. Well, that's a good start for a new video. One of us killed. And of course it was the Dracoon. Oh man, well, my companions carry me away. In the end, one of the marksmen got killed, one Dracoon. We got 10 of them. Well, that was a horrible result for me. I should have been more careful. And that's well, that was the first time that's happened. First happened to me, but that was a good shot from there. Wait a minute, who was the healer? Oksana. I really should put her on a separate squad. Can't possibly hit from this distance. What am I doing? I'm a bit rusty today, am I? Am I not? Well, come here and get shot. There we go. Well done. A Swedish rider. 39 wage. That puts this Swedish rider pretty much elite cavalry, I guess. Doesn't get much better than that. I need to check his stats. 18-13. 95. I guess I could use a saber like that. This hat. Oh, I get bullets. Excellent. Not very good, but better than nothing. Whoa! Sir, it is said that there can be no friendship between women, but let me say this. I can always count on Oksana. She cured all my cart horses and prepared a broth for me to cast out fever. I was back on my feet the very next day. Okay, so Ingrid and Oksana are actually friends. That's good. That'll help them. Help them keep happy, even if there are some companions in the party who they don't like. I say that she's the worthiest among your followers. Make it known to all that any man who lays a finger on her shall sup on rotten horse flesh for the remainder of journey. I hear you, Ingrid. I hear you. Very good. Maybe Ingrid shares that. Shares that either, but I still wonder what Fatima and Ingrid think about each other. Ingrid didn't like Alkirdas. Right, but do you have bullets for your weapons? Yes, you do. Actually, pretty good bullets. Yalisei has a weapon, but I don't think any bullets yet, yeah. So you can have those. Those are not very good, but better than nothing. 25. Okay, you can keep that. And Oksana can get a funny cap. And you can also get... Oh, you don't have strength for that, right. Maybe I should give you a... firearm at some point, since you will be support. Okay, let's take a look at you. Swedish writer. Level 21. 180. Wow. That was a good find. As a rescued prisoner. Shooting from horseback 6. Oh yeah, I'm liking you. You are more than welcome, and I should probably find some more cavalry like that. And I was thinking of putting Oksana in the back and putting her in a support group, but now that I think of it again, for now I will keep her up there so she can eventually get into the fights and. Get into the fights and get some experience. Right, I saw some more bandits here. $152 per week. Yeah, it's quite costly that heavy cavalry. I think he'll be worth it when we get into fights. Prince Mikhail Vishnevetsky, Polish Commonwealth. Oh, the villagers have money as well. Maybe I can sell some stuff here. Oh, and good price for flour here. I'll sell you one. Yes, indeed. The Swedes and the Polish-Lithuanian Commonwealth are in war. I guess. Vilna. Let's see if we can find a companion with good pathfinding. Book merchant. A ransom broker. Well, that'll do. I would get a better price from the slave trader, but let's talk to this guy. Good day, sir. I suppose I could be used to you. How could you be of use to me anyway? Oh, Carl's mustache, so great. You know what me do for living, no? Ah, listen then. Me broker ransom for prisoners. Me travels long way. From the salt mines to the slave markets on the coast, and I don't know why I'm talking in an Indian accent. Along the way, we comes across some mysterious tracking captive men. We buys prisoners and sell to the slavers. You have prisoners to sell, my lord. At a good price, you know. Well, what if their families can't pay? Oh, then me spin them a sad tale. Life on the galleys, suddenly even very poor peasants digs treasures out of his cowshed, oh my. What would you pay for a prisoner? It vary. Me have a good nose for ransoms. One look at the man can tell me whether they goes to bed hungry or dines each night on soft dumplings and goose. The real monies, of course, is the gentry. We know every land-owning house here, the estates, the heraldry, their offspring, and of course their credit with the merchants. Well, would you be able to ransom me if I'm taken? Of course, my lord, of course. Keep the silver buried somewhere deep, and tell a loyal servant what to do when you get captured. Can I actually do that in this game? Well, that's all I need to know. If that's the case, that'll be awesome. I guess the option will be if I get myself a fee for or castle or town. Right, well, how about you buy these rebels off me? Yeah, I will sell. I'll get some more. But I would get a lot better price selling them as slaves. But that'll speed me up so I can catch up more bandits. Oh, master, I can bear much but not a witch in the party. The shaman tricks of that Oksana are not to my liking, not at all. The other day she came and offered me a luck charm. To me, a Muslim, when Allah damns the infidels to death. Yeah, so Ingrid doesn't like Fatima. And the other way around. I'm sorry Fatima, but I'm keeping Oksana for now. Well, slowly figuring out the relationships between the likes and dislikes of the companions. Could go to Lviv, and these Kazakh countries. The problem is there are probably mounted bandits there, but I'll keep my eyes open. Caravan. If I was a bandit, I'd be close to these bridges. Oh, there's some war going on in here as well. Scouts. Foragers. Ah, Bratislava. Siege? Yes, the Kazakhs are sieging. What do we have here? Ah, the Kazakhs are fighting Crimean Khanate. Okay. Having hard time finding enough bandits to fight. Pop visitor, right. What do we have here? Tools seem relatively cheap. Flour is cheap here. I think that is something that I will trade. Let Ingrid figure out where to sell. Okay, so wool cloth. Writing these down again. Wool cloth would be good to sell in Vilna. Tools. Chernikov. Leatherwork. Well, leatherwork and flour. I think I will take that flour deal. Kiev powder. Yeah, I think that flower deal is something that it's good to me right now. Leatherwork is fine. Tools are a bit out of my budget, as is wool cloth. So let's get as many flour as I can. Leave me 170. That'll leave me 200. So that should be good, right? Ah, weekly cost 152. I do want to have money for the weekly wages at all times. Right, so now I should take those two. Azak Kale. How far is that? It's there. So I will take a look at the towns in between. And that's probably just the best place to sell. I also saw some bandits here. No, rebels. Same thing. But I can't catch them now that I'm carrying so much flour, can I? At least I can't see them at night. Battle. No, still can't see him. Can I go here and sell my flower even at this battle? How much you pay for flour during a siege? Not much, right. Okay. Sounds. Let's visit Kiev on the way. '88. Well, that's okay-ish. Over 100 would be better. I will sell some here, just to get some money in case I run in some bad bandits. Any good companions? Oh, different kind of tavern. Pop visitor, mercenary helper, yeah. A priest! Traveler, ransom broker. Who are you? Do I know you? Well, my name is Carl. I am Mehmed of the Crimean Kirays. I thought Crimean Khanate was ruled by Khan Islam Kiray. Ah, right, so you are the claimant to the throne of the Khanate. I am the elder son of Khan Selyamet. Until recently, the Khan's palace in Bak Shisaray was my rightful dwelling, but the Sultan of the port, Porte, to whom all Jirei swear allegiance, considered me unfit for my duties and put my younger brother Islam in my place. Oh, a brother. My being disposed was a terrible injustice. Islam Kirei knows nothing of stately affairs, and rather than supporting the Polish Commonwealth, he aims for a union with the Cossacks. Only together with the Polish king can we hold back the Dragon of Moscow in its onslaught south. Well, to me it seems that your brother has declared war on Polish Commonwealth, but I guess that's one way to a formal union. I seek trusted allies. If the Crimean Mirzas would take my side, then the Sultan would have no choice but to appoint me Khan once more. Yeah. We'll see about that later. Mercenary halberdier, pop visitor, tavern keeper. What would a priest be doing in tavern? My son, allow me to bless your meal and recite a beautiful, elaborate prayer which shall bring you luck in battle. For this, I only ask a few mugs of cool beer. Well, God bless Holy Father. Why are you wandering the pubs? For a while I am, how should I say, I have ceased to take up the holy orders. Oh? I am the priest, Spaso Kukotski. The bishop of Riga gave me a small village parish, but within a week he sent his sacrist there to check how well I was fulfilling my duties. After the Sunday mass, this boar came to my humble cell. First he inquired what a parish woman was doing in my bed, and then had the gall to start preaching to me. He explained that one should not spin the censer over one's head during the sermon. And I endured his condescension well enough. He said that prayers should be concluded by the word Amen, and not by the word I spoke at end. Still I remained silent. The parish loved my way of doing things, you understand? But then when he began to shout that he saw goods from my church being sold at the Riga market, I could no longer stand it any longer, and beat him with a staff so hard he barely made it out alive. Okay. Learning of this, the bishop sent a mercenary band to deal with me. I did not wait for them to come, but took my belongings and fled to the woods. Soon I found out that I had been defrocked and excommunicated by the bishop. Well, I can't really blame the bishop, I guess, but I think a priest, even a defrocked priest, would be a welcome addition to my party if you would like to come. I accept this offer with pleasure, my son. I swear by sweet Mary, Mother of God, you shall not regret it. Very well. Church services, it's not my only trade. I wield a pike quite well, and if you should ever need to persuade someone, I can do it even if it's a dead body. I do detest cowards, however. Okay, so you don't like if I retreat from a battle, I guess. Well, I hope your quick tongue will be used to us. Oh, and you were free! Welcome! I like you even more. Excellent. Give me a few moments to get ready and I'll be ready to move. Nice. Hopefully the witch and priest get along. Speaking of witch, let's check priestess stats first. Okay, he's a medic as well. Okay. And a looter. And has some trade. Well, this is interesting, because that actually puts... I don't necessarily need... No, wait a minute. What am I talking about? When Fatima said she didn't like someone, it was of course Oksana. I should have read that message. I was talking about the witch, not Ingrid. So Oksana and Fatima don't get along. You are happy, so you don't... Yeah, of course, because you have a friend in the party. But what do you think about things, Fatima? You are content. What about Ingrid? Not the stats, I meant that one. Happy. Yeah, well, we'll see.